Hi, I'm Anne from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you. Today I'm thinking about Europa. Europa is a moon that orbits the planet Jupiter. We've learned a lot of things about the moons of Jupiter by looking through telescopes and sending spaceships to go out near the planets. When we send spaceships very close to other planets and moons, we can get more and more information about what they're like. Scientists have found that Europa has a thick layer of ice on the outside, but underneath is an ocean of liquid salty water and a metal core, just like Earth. This is the type of place that's the best to search for life. Do you think that there could be creatures living under the sea, under the ice of Europa? Here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there were three friends who loved imagining that they were space explorers. They were Millie, Ruth, and Lou. One day, they were playing in the rocket ship playhouse and dreaming up places that they would want to explore. Millie said, "If you could travel anywhere in the whole solar system, where would you want to go?" Ruth said, "Well, we already know that Venus and Mercury are too hot and too stinky." Lou said, "And Mars has been done. Sorry, Mo." Millie said, "What about one of the moons of Jupiter? I have a book about the moons of Jupiter, and some of them are as big as planets." She showed them the book, and they all looked at the pictures. Lou said, "Wow, I like the idea of visiting Europa. It shows here that there's a big ocean under the ice that covers the planet. Anything could be in that ocean." Ruth said, "We would need to be astronaut aquanauts. We would have to travel through space and under an ocean." Millie said, "We would need a new kind of spaceship for that. One that could fly through space, then drill through the ice, and then plunge into the ocean." Lou said, "Maybe there's another ship, an aquapod that we launch once we're in the alien ocean. Let's pretend that we're on the spaceship now, the Aquanaut 3000. We're headed to Jupiter and its moon." Millie started the countdown and they all joined in. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, liftoff. Millie said, "Okay, we have to go out past the moon and Mars and through the asteroid belt toward Jupiter." Lou said, "Wow, there are so many little space rocks out in this part of the solar system." Ruth said, "I see Jupiter in the viewer, and we'll pass the other moons of Jupiter on the way, like Ganymede and Callisto. There, isn't that Europa now?" Millie said, "Yes, I can tell by the crisscross lines in the ice. That's Europa." Lou said, "Let's take our ship in. We'll have to spin the drill." The three friends spun around and around until they got dizzy. Then they sat down on the floor. Lou said, "We're through the ice. Hop in the aquapod and let's explore the sea." The three friends sat on the top of the slide and counted 3, 2, 1, 0. Splash! They slid down the slide and into the ocean of Europa. They drifted along under the sea. Millie whispered, "It's so dark under the ice. Ooh, did you see that sparkly shimmer over there? So pretty." Lou said, "The shimmery little specks are blinking on and off like fireflies. Maybe they're talking to each other with light." Ruth said, "There are lots of green glowing bubbles. Is that a jellyfish?" She pointed at a long flowing thing they could see out the window. It glowed brightly in the sea and waved long glowing tentacles at them. Lou said, "Let's turn on the aquapod light and see if we can see anything else in the dark." Millie said, "What's that? It looks like a seal, but it's purple. It's spinning around and flipping over." Ruth said, "Cute. Hi, friend." She spun around and waved at the creature. Lou said, "Whoa, look at that over there. That thing is really big. Do you see it? It's all spotted and blobby." Millie said, "Amazing. We should get back to the ship and make a report of our findings. The scientists back on Earth will want to know. We're not alone. There is life out here." "Bye, Europa creature," said Ruth, and they all waved. Then they ran to the rocket and climbed inside. "What a great trip to Europa," said Lou. Ruth said, "Let's draw pictures of our spaceship and all the creatures we saw on the trip." "It's fun to have good friends to explore with," said Millie, and they gave each other a high five. It's craft time. Today we're going to make our own scientific journals. What you need for this activity is scissors. You need some things to write with, like pencils, and you need just a piece of white paper or colored paper. Now what we're going to do is we're going to make a journal where it has several pages where you can write your own notes about what you observe outside or your ideas about a certain topic. So this will give us a couple of different pages to write down our notes. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our piece of paper and we're going to fold it in half one time, just like this, and then we're going to fold it in half again. And this is going to make a nice book size. And now, to make this into a book that we can write in, we'll have four pages, but we're just going to cut along the bottom part of this folded part right here. So I'm going to slide my scissors in, and I'm just going to cut along the fold almost to the end, and cut on each folded part. So there should be two places where you cut. And now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 pages of a notebook. And now this will be the cover of my notebook, and I can write down on the cover my name, the date. So here on this one, you can see I put it's Anne's notes, and I put that the date on the top so I know when I was writing about it. And this is my notebook about Europa, all of my ideas about Europa, which is a moon of Jupiter. And so I have a picture here of Jupiter and the moon. It's orbiting around Jupiter. And this is my idea of what it looks like. It has ice on the outside, and I drew a picture of the ocean that's underneath Europa and its core. So these are some things that I know already about the planet and my idea about how we might be able to make a spaceship that could drill down through the ice and then get into the ocean. And then I started to draw some ideas of mine of what I might find in the ocean of Europa. And I still have two more pages to draw more ideas with my colored pencils about what I might see in the oceans of Europa. This is an idea for you that you can do to draw just your ideas about things or your observations of things that you see outside your window or around your house. And this scientific journal is something that's important for all scientists to write down their ideas and keep track of them and when they had their ideas. So I hope you use this. Please try it out, and also give us a like on our video if you enjoy our craft times and our story times. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get our videos every time we upload one. Thanks so much for joining us. Goodbye.